such a good girl.
Hello?
Good afternoon. I'm calling from a local animal shelter. Do you know that there are thousands of animals in shelters and we care for them until they can be adopted? Without your support, they'll have to be put to sleep. You don't want that to happen, do you?
Of course not.
Great. We've got sponsorship levels starting at just $15 a month. That's about 50 cents a day. Can you help us?
I would love to. Do you take credit cards?
We do.
Just a moment. Let me get my purse.
Can I help you?
I hope so. My name is Tony. I've had a bit of a rough time, and I'm trying to get back on the straight and narrow. I'm trying to get some money to go to college by selling these magazine subscriptions. You read magazines, right?
Yes, I do.
Well, great. I can get you a better deal on any magazine that you want, and it's going to help pay my way to college. All you need to do is pick a couple of magazines, and I can get you taken care of.
Young man, can you tell me something about the company?
Well, it's called Credits for College, and it's a national charity, and we're all over the country.
But how does the program work?
Well, it's like I said, for every magazine subscription that I sell, I can get credits and they'll help pay my way for college.
But how does the program work?
Well, it's kind of complicated, and all I really know is that it's going to help pay my way to college. I'm trying to make something of myself.
Okay, well, I tell you what, I'm not interested right now, but if you leave me some paperwork, I'll be more than happy to take a look at it, and then I'll get back with you.
Well, I don't have any paperwork. I'll have to come back.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. You have a great day.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Arizona Attorney General Terry Goddard. I'm guessing you found yourself on the receiving end of one of those charity appeals or something very similar. What you do next is very important, and that's what we're going to talk about here today. Most charities are highly reputable organizations providing much-needed help and assistance to those in need. However, there are also some fake charities out there that have legitimate sounding names or names very close to that of a well-known charity. Often these organizations are nothing more than scams. This video is designed to help you be an informed donor and avoid the scammers.
Let's start by defining what a charity is. Simply put, it's an organization created to support the public good and help those in need. To do that, most charities rely on fundraising to pay their bills, pay for their programs, and raise more money.
The first thing you should do is get as much information as you can. What is the tax status of the entity? Then the next thing you should do is ask in writing what the purpose is for which these funds will be used. For example, will some of the proceeds be used to pay the solicitor? Now, there's nothing wrong necessarily about paying a solicitor. Charities often do that, hire professional companies, but you want to know how much percentage will be going to the solicitor as opposed to the organization. In addition to the door-to-door solicitations that we might recall having, people are now using every means of communication, including web pages, Twitter, Facebook. Again, in all of those cases where you're approached electronically or by email, you still need to do the same things as if someone knocked on your front door. There's a lot of scams out there, and the worse the economy gets, the more scams that there are.
When charity fraud occurs, it makes big news, but at that point, it's often hard to get your money back. So here are some things to do before giving. The most important thing you can do is ask lots of questions. No matter how you are contacted, get the name of who you are talking with and a phone number and address of the charity. Ask how your donation will be used and what percentage will go to help those in need. Ask for proof that your donation is tax deductible. To get this, the charity must be a Section 501(c)(3) organization. Ask for a copy of their most recent Form 990 and financial statement. Remember, it's your money. Don't make a hasty decision. A real charity shouldn't have a problem with any of these requests and actions that we've already outlined. If you're unsure or need more time, tell them.
Try to do your own research first before you go in and you know, donate. A lot of the times when people call in, they'll say, you know, I really want to give to this. How do I know it's legitimate or not?
One place to find answers to that question is the internet. There are a number of websites that can give you information about a charity and how it spends its money. The first is the Arizona Secretary of State's website. Many charities in Arizona must register and provide financial statements to the Secretary of State, and the registration information is then posted on the website. But there are many other resources at your disposal as well.
At the Better Business Bureau, we do more than just handle complaints. We're also a great resource for free charitable giving information for Arizona consumers. Whether you are looking for information on a specific charity or just want to browse through a list of those that meet ethical standards, BBB has free charity reports that you can trust. Those free reports include contact information, details on programs, finances, governance, fundraising methods, tax status, and whether or not the organization meets the BBB's 20 standards for charitable accountability. BBB charity reports are available online at www.bbb.org/charity.
Examples of other resources are charitynavigator.org and guidestar.org. They both have lots of information that can help you make an educated decision with your money.
One scam tactic we hear about frequently at the BBB is a donor being pressured to donate on the spot. Remember, a legitimate charity won't use high-pressure pitches to get you to donate. They will gladly accept your donation today, next week, or even next month. Also, don't be fooled by impressive-looking websites or emails that closely resemble a well-known charity. Verify that the charity is who they say that they are. A little research will ensure that your money goes towards the cause rather than into somebody's pocket.
Be cautious with your money and be wary of charities that spring up overnight based on current events or natural disasters. Never give cash. It can be lost or stolen. Plus, you'll need a record of your donation for your taxes. And finally, trust your gut. If something doesn't feel right, do more research. Or simply say no. When you're ready to donate, send a check directly to the organization. That way you know your money is going where you want it to.
If you have any questions about the information we've covered here today or a charity that's contacted you, please call us at the Arizona Attorney General's office or visit our website at azag.gov. Donating to a charity is a really good thing to do. Just make sure you know who you're donating to and how your money will be used. It's your money. Make it count.